Good evening, everyone. I can't see all of you out there, but I hope that there are hordes and hordes of us joining us tonight for our 2023 Izaak Walton Award event being brought to you tonight virtually. And we will have a live gathering tomorrow. But for those of you who couldn't join us tomorrow, we think it's going to be a wonderful evening tonight. This is our 10th Izaak Walton Award event. And tonight we are celebrating a very special individual, a wonderful woman in Nancy Zakon. My name's Fred Palimas. I serve at the American Museum of Fly Fishing on the board, help on the board. And so I'm here to sort of kick things off, but it's gonna be a fun evening. You're gonna hear some really fascinating stories from a number of individuals that know Nancy and have known Nancy over the years. Nancy has made incredible contributions, deep and varied and countless into the fly angling community. And of course, with a focus on women in the sport of fly angling. And so we've got a great gathering tonight of female panelists, all of whom share this passion that Nancy shares, and all of whom have made contributions. Rather than my going into a lot of detail on the specifics that Nancy has contributed to the fly angling arena, I'm gonna make a brief introduction and then move off screen. Our MC tonight, our hostess is Sara Low, who's joining us from Providence, Rhode Island. And actually I should mention that the panelists are actually scattered all over the place. I'm down here in Key Largo, and Mary Bloom is here in Key Largo and Nancy's here in Key Largo, but Sara will let you know. Sara, who's in Providence, will let you know where others are and who they all are, and she'll make the formal introductions. But I do want to say just a couple of quick words about Sara, because Sara is somebody who's made a lot of contributions into the fly angling arena as well. She has done much to advance the opportunities for women in fly fishing. And so she deserved some accolades there. She wrote a book, and Sara, help me with the title. I think it's Guides to Fly Fishing Mistakes.
A guide's guide to
Fly Fishing Mistakes, Common Problems, and How to Fix Them or How to Correct Them.
Yes.
Sara is a licensed guide in New York State, an accomplished angler with, I don't know, several decades of experience under her belt. She at one point was running a destination travel company that focused on fly fishing trips. In 2010, she curated a show at the Catskill Fly Fishing Center titled A History of Women in Fly Fishing, and she was recognized that year by the Catskill Fly Fishing Center as Outstanding Fly Fisher of the Year. So Sara brings a lot of her own contributions to the table, and I think she's gonna help introduce Nancy and all of the folks, the panelists that are with us tonight. So without further ado from me, I'm going to turn the floor over, the virtual floor over to you, Sara. And I look forward to hearing some really fascinating stories from everyone. So enjoy the evening. And thank you all for being with us.
Thank you, Fred. Thank you very much. I too am very excited to be here to honor Nancy with the American Museum of Fly Fishing Izaak Walton Award. Nancy Zakon, Izaak Walton, a good fit. Izaak Walton is a father of fly fishing, having written a book about the sport, the book about the sport, The Compleat Angler. Anglers have bowed to him for fly fishing since 1653. Nancy Zakon is a leader, especially to women in fly fishing. They bow to her. She is a bestseller in her own way. Highlights of Nancy's fishing career include when she was little, when Nancy Zakon was 11 years old, her father taught her how to fly fish on a small pond near their home in Alabama. Nancy joined the Orvis store, this is years later, and taught women to cast and fish. She founded two clubs, one in New York City and one in Key West, Florida. She was involved with the International Women of Fly Fishing, IWFF. She was a member, a director, and a president. A trustee of the American Museum of Fly Fishing, Nancy's just done it all. We love her and all feel this way about Nancy, judging from the number of participants on tonight's Zoom call. The museum has put together a short video about Nancy. I like to call it, "This is your fishing life, Nancy." Please watch your screen as we roll the footage.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Woods King, and I'm the co-chair of the Angler Circle for the American Museum of Fly Fishing. I'm thrilled to be here with everyone to celebrate Nancy Zakon and her award tonight. Grateful for her service. I'm inspired by her dedication. I love her passion for fly fishing and its history, and I feel lucky to call her a friend. Nancy's support of the Angler Circle initiatives over the years was amazing and really inspired those to become museum-wide initiatives and helped us get to where we are today. We definitely wouldn't be where we are without her, and her support, especially with the film projects that we've gotten involved in, you know, her kind of pushing us to dive feet first into that has been an unbelievable experience, from everything through the fly fishing film tour, the wonders of wildlife, and really, you know, all the initiatives that have kind of come from both the museum and the Angler Circle. You know, really, she's made us all feel like we've had a seat at the table. And that's been an unbelievable experience. And Nancy, I just want to say thank you, and we really appreciate it. Congratulations.
So many memories of the early days, the mid-90s. I remember them as the pioneering days, especially when you invited me to the old Orvis store by Grand Central Station to read from my new book, Little Rivers. And what a thrill it was to see a room full of women. And so many were there that some of them had to sit on the floor. But that wasn't a problem because they were outdoor women. And it was the beginning of a renaissance that moved into the quickly into the formation of IFWF, the International Women's Fly Fishing Association, which you were part of, I believe, and also Casting for Recovery, which was founded around that time. And I believe you're on the board for that too, Nancy. So you've had your finger in the mix for a long time, championing women in your genteel, ladylike, generous, sage, strong way. You were a steady and wise influence on us all, and such a beautiful Georgia peach. So I hope we get to see each other again sometime in the future. And again, many, many congratulations. I hope you have a wonderful celebration after this event. And it's so well deserved, Nancy. Thank you.
Nancy. It's your old buddy, Paul, here. Just wish you a big congratulations on the Izaak Walton Award. Nobody deserves it more, Nancy. You know, all the work that you've done through the years with women and Juliana Barons up in New York City and the Bonefish Bonnies down in the Florida Keys and all the great, you know, dedication to this fabulous sport. I love you, Nancy, and congratulations once again.
Oh, that's so good.
Sweet.
Ladies and gentlemen, woman of the day, Nancy Zakon. We love you, Nancy. Thank you. Nancy, congratulations on being honored with this important award. You are so very deserving of this recognition. Did you ever imagine that your fishing venture would take you this far? You don't stop. What compels you to continue founding fishing organizations or freshening up existing ones?
It's the love of teaching women about fly fishing. You know, it is such a thrill. All of you on the panel know this. When you fish yourself, it is a true joy of fishing, the whole experience. But when you teach someone else and share it with someone else, you really double it for yourself. And we all know this. And it just keeps you going. It just keeps you going. So there are always creative ideas, fun new things, new people bring ideas in. It's critical to have new people coming into your organization to change things up, to refresh it, to keep the enthusiasm going. And I love it. I love every moment of it. Thanks.
Well, we are all lucky for that as well. Thank you, Nancy. It seems that many of the people watching feel the same way. We're getting messages for Nancy from some of our audience. We will give all of your tributes to Nancy. So keep sending them in. She will see them.
Thank you.
Thanks, Nancy. As MC, I send a special shout out to some of the anglers online. I'm not allowed to do this, but I am. I'm calling out the members of Juliana's Anglers Sporting Club, the outdoor women's organization that was the New York Fishing Club started by Nancy. Hello, girls. More on that later. We have a distinguished panel waiting to talk about Nancy and fly fishing. I am honored to introduce this group of women, the first all-female panel hosted by the American Museum of Fly Fishing. The panelists are Mary Bloom in Key Largo, Florida, Fanny Krieger in San Francisco, California, Lori Ann Murphy in, are you in Belize today, Lori Ann?
I live here, Sarah.
I figured that, okay, just in case you'd move. I mean, I know you're there. Okay, and Joan Wulff in Livingston Manor, New York. I'm in Providence, Rhode Island. Here, looking at us, we are a truly national Pan-American panel. Nancy, these women are here to discuss your exploits in fly fishing. Any comment from you before they have the chance to tell their tales?
I just thank you all so much. I love you dearly. It's gonna make me cry. I thank you so much for being here and sharing. You've been a real big part of my life through all these years. And thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Now we'll hear from the panelists though and what they have to say. Lori Ann Murphy, a trailblazing fly fishing guide and entrepreneur, was dedicated over 30 years to the sport. Throughout the years, she has become a pioneer in the industry, helping design fishing gear and clothing for women for Orvis, leading women's fishing trips with real women in the US and now in Belize, winning fishing awards both for her techniques as well as for her ambassadorship, including winning the International Sportsman's Exposition Best of the West Casting Competition. Lori Ann has been instrumental in every way in increasing the visibility of women in fly fishing. While doing so, Lori Ann, You must have shared many fishing events with Nancy. Would you share one with us?
Thank you. Thank you, Sara. Nancy, just so thrilled to be here. I'm just so excited to honor you. And just Paul said it well, just well deserved. And I'm so proud of our story because Nance and I, and I call Nancy Nance, and it's always been that way. And it's just like we were thrown into teaching. In 1993, we started the first Orvis School for Women. And so we met each other out there, and everybody had their different styles, and that was great. And that was all fun. And then, but our job description kept growing as pros on the Orvis team at the time. And then we're at Fly Tackle Dealer Show, and we're working long hours, and you know, all of a sudden we're just like rah, 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 rah. And then all of a sudden we just started busting up laughing, and we realized, you know, we had different ways of doing things, and but we came to common ground. And that's why I'm just so proud, especially because that's what a real friendship's all about, and real, you know, shake hands and what this whole thing is about. And so, and to light up your face, Nance, and she's just always been great. And so then we're at, you know, all of a sudden we segue and we run out the door and we go to the Rolling Stones concert in Denver. And you know, here we just had this big like
great time.
Yeah, come to Jesus time, and then all of a sudden we're like, all right now, and we're just like, you know, just having such a fun time. And then Nance has always asked for my stories from the field, which has been really fun for me because that's kept us connected in so many ways. And I just also want to mention Alan, because you've always just talked about him with such reverence as in your life. And when you guys, when I would see you on the river, the Madison or something, you know, just, it just really could tell that you're true companions and wonderful love. And happy to know him as well, but I am proud of us. I'm just tickled.
I've got to tell a story about Lorianne, and that is, Alan and I were fishing in Everglades City, which is unique in itself. It's a 50s throwback kind of place. And we were staying at the Everglades Rod and Glutton, which sounds pretty fancy, but it's pretty basic. At any rate, we're sitting on the porch before dinner, and I see this flats boat coming in. And somebody's poling it in the back, and somebody's fishing off the front coming into the canal. And I look and I said, oh my gosh, that's Lorianne Murphy. I can't believe it. She's here. She's fishing off the front. And look who's poling in the back. It's Steve Huff, one of the most famous guides in the Everglades. And it was like Hollywood just rolled down, you know, the canal. It was really a blast and fun seeing you there and Sherry. And I wanted to tell you something else. When we started the Orvis New York Schools for Women, the very first ones ever offered, after the schools, Lorianne and her partner there, Christy Ball, who was a Western guide as well, founded the Real Women Outfitters. And it was just the genesis of, you know, it's still going. Real women out, you know, real women are still doing it and having their fabulous trips. And I went the club route, thinking I want women in New York City to be able to find each other in order to fish together, because once you leave the schools, there's no partner to fish with unless your husband fished or your boyfriend fished. So it was really the genesis of a lot of women inspiration at that point for Lorianne and for myself as well. It was very.
We didn't know what was going to happen, but what happened is we had those 20. It was so great to see Margo.
I agree.
She's just fabulous with her words. Hi, Margo. Anyway, at that time, and then what happened is we had 27 women that were all pumped up and so excited, and then they said they wanted to go on fishing trips. And Fanny's been leading fishing trips for such a long time from San Francisco. Joan's been, I got to go, you know, be with Joan and learn her instructor ways and watch her in action, and you know, just the whole mesh that we've been able to experience. And just really, you've been just a shining light in all of it. Yes.
Playing hard at fly fishing and working hard, obviously.
Yes.
I mean, relaxing hard, so, which is wonderful. But let's move over to Fanny Krieger. Fanny is a legend in the world of fly fishing. She began to fish as part of a fishing date with her future husband. From that moment, Fanny never stopped. She fished, built a business around the sport, started the Golden West Women's Fly Fishers in San Francisco, a club for women looking for friends in the world of fly fishing. She expanded her reach. She founded and became the first president of the International Women Fly Fishers, a festival for women anglers. She was inducted into the North California Council of the Federation of Fly Fishers Hall of Fame. Fanny, you have inspired anglers and women who want to become anglers, fishing clubs, and fishing clubs to be. Thanks to you, one of the women inspired was Nancy Zakon. Tell us a tale involving Nancy and fly fishing.
Well, thank you for this wonderful introduction. I'm awed by this woman you just talked about. Anyway, I did meet Nancy at before one of the very first International Women Fly Fisher, IWFF. And Nancy and I talked for hours because we shared a room. We talked for hours about women in fly fishing and how it would be wonderful if we could have some kind of an organization or a club or something. And basically that's how IWFF was started. Just a late evening talk between Nancy and I. But there's more to it. Nancy is a incredibly generous, open person, friend. She and I were in a small town in Pennsylvania, probably for one of the festival. I forgot the details, but we passed by a store where there was in the window on display, beautiful sweaters. And I just kept drooling, looking at those sweaters. And without me knowing, Nancy went in and bought me one of those sweaters.
Wow.
It was such a wonderful, wonderful moment. And I thought, you know, how generous, how caring a person can be. So I feel like Nancy has been a model for me and I owe her a lot. Thank you, Nancy.
Thank you.
I owe you a lot, Sarah, if I can just interject. Joan Wulff, when I first met Joan, she'll tell you about it, maybe. Joan said, you need to call Fanny Krieger. And we've been friends ever since. So Fanny, thank you, my dear. You have done so much for women in fishing, so much, and continue to do it. You know, that flame is still bright for fishing and women in you. Thank you.
Always a help. Thank you very much, Fanny.
Thank you.
Mary Bloom. Mary Bloom is the immediate past president of Bonefish Bonnies, a fly fishing club in Key Largo, Florida, started by Nancy, that celebrates women anglers whose mission is to gather for fishing, fun, and friendship. Taking advantage of the surrounding waters, I believe that Bonefish Bonnies does most of its fishing in salt water. Mary, I am sure that you have great Nancy stories. Let's hear one of your favorites.
Well, my first Nancy story, interestingly enough, was not fly fishing. It was offshore. I was a brand new Bonnie in 2010. And at the time, we had a tournament called No Rules. It's now called the Fishing Fanatics. It's a nice way to get new people, new women involved in a tournament setting for fun. But Nancy, as the immediate past president, not only the founder, generously, I met her at one of the first meetings, and she invited me to fish with her team on her boat with Alan. Now, I've never been one personally to enjoy getting dressed up and doing costumey things. But at that time, the Bonefish Bonnies, this fun tournament, we had, you had to have a theme. And that year, the theme was Bonnies Go Green. Now, of course, conservation in 2010 was really starting to take on. And just about every other team did something along conservation, you know, recycling, something. I still don't know to this day, but I think it was Nancy who came up with the idea that we would do green mal de mer, seasickness. So I figured if the founder of the Bonefish Bonnies could paint her face green, I certainly could too. So we didn't win that. We didn't win for fish that day, but we won for the costumes. So thank you, Nancy. That was my introduction to tournament fishing and my first time fishing with Nancy. Since then, she's been my mentor in my 4 years as president. She's been my friend. She's been my instructor. She was really my first instructor. She continues to volunteer all of her time for the Bonnies. The Bonefish Bonnies here in Key Largo are really blessed because we have Nancy. We also have Mona Brewer, who's a certified fly fishing instructor. And Mona and Nancy spend countless hours free, giving of their time freely to introduce women to fly fishing. And not only to introduce them, but for those of us who are sort of permanently stuck at low intermediate, we have touch-up clinics all the time. And it's just wonderful. I'll get into a little bit more of the history of the Bonnies in a little bit. But I just wanted to end by saying, you know, Nancy, you know how much I love you. And the best way I could describe Nancy is another Bonnie who's a friend once told me the definition of poise that she learned. Poise, and Nancy fits this to a T, poise is the art of raising your eyebrow, not your voice. And Nancy, that's
really well said.
I mean you've led through your gentleness, through your kindness, your steel magnolia. We love you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mary. That's really sweet of you. Thank you so much. Mary
did a super
job. She took the club through COVID, which is pretty darn hard to do when you can't. So kudos, my dear.
Thank you, Nancy. Thank you.
That's wonderful. Thank you. All right. Now let's hear from a new voice, Joan Wulff. She began fly casting in 1937, moving to become a national casting champion from 1943 to 1960. Along the way, winning a national fisherman's distance event against all male competition in 1951. She has cast a fly 161 feet. She was a professional in the fishing tackle business for the Garcia Corporation and for Winston Rods from 1958 until 2019. An author of 4 books, a writer of a magazine column about casting for 22 years, a world globetrotter to places fly fishing, sharing her techniques and lessons at the Wolf School of Fly Fishing, a member of the Fly Fishing Hall of Fame and the International Game Fish Association Fishing Hall of Fame. Joan joins us as the ultimate inspiration, deserving the title, the First Lady of Fly Fishing, and to broaden that to include the male anglers, one of fly fishing's greatest 20th century pioneers. I would imagine her head is probably as big as can be, but she deserves everything. Joan, I know that you were also an inspiration to Nancy in many ways. Tell us one of your favorite interactions with her.
Well, I've got to tell you first that I have never fished with Nancy. And when I hear all of what you're saying about her, it makes me feel terrible that I was doing other things and wasn't there.
So, oh, no.
Oh, but the difference between Nancy and me is that my bringing women into the sport was always from a distance. I wrote about it. I made films about it. I did teach it, yes. But Nancy was right out there taking each woman personally by the hand and teaching them to fly fish. And I envy that. And I just realized one of the things, I've had a wonderful life, but I never spent enough time sharing fishing with women. Because I got into it when it was a man's sport, my fishing companions have really always been men, which has got its advantages, as you can imagine. And so I think that the only story I have to tell is that when Nancy and I started talking after my being at the Orvis store about her starting a club for women in New York City. And I said, you should talk to Fanny Krieger, because she started with another woman, the Golden West Women Fly Fishers. Now, of course, we may have to call our club the Acid Rain East Fly Fishers. but Nancy went on to start the Julianas.
I'm glad there's some rain in there too, probably.
Totally laughing. Mm-hmm. I too would like to share a tale about Nancy. Founder of the club in New York City, the Julianas Anglers, Nancy and the club had spent the club's first couple of years in freshwater fly fishing. Even so, there was the saltwater trip to Rhode Island. We were so serious and thought we knew about everything. We packed up our knowledge, which was really based on freshwater fly fishing, our gear, and trekked up to Rhode Island. We fished off rocks for striped bass, bluefish, and false albacore. I'm setting the scene. Then we moved to a beach. Nancy and I and the other women used our knowledge of fishing and gear to fly fish on the sand. Salt water moves. There are tides, currents, and waves. Nancy and I dealt with the movement of the water while clad in big, chest-high, freshwater waders with felt-soled boots. Every wave brought warm water into our waders. Our belts did not seem to help. Soon, Nancy and I were each waterlogged and weighed down. We could not move. Our waders were so full of water. Of course, neither of us wanted to speak up about this for fear of our guide's reaction. When the beach fishing ended, Nancy and I peeled off our waders, standing in tubs that immediately filled with wader water. We were drenched to the bone and laughing hysterically. I still laugh at our great first saltwater attempt. Thank you, Nancy, for the continued giggles and the fabulous experience.
Oh man, you guys, that's bad.
You lived through it.
That's pretty bad.
Yeah, really bad. Really bad.
Orianne, do you have waiters in Belize? No.
No, but you know what people do ask. And so it's actually kind of interesting sometimes because people we've been at this for such a long time that you just assume certain things, you know, that people understand, and that's just so incorrect. So, you know, I mean, it's very real. People ask if they need to bring their waders and boots. No, you don't.
Think of that, Lorianne. Let's broaden this subject to discuss women in the general world of fly fishing, and especially our panel members' own experiences as women in fly fishing. Mary, have you ever seen the makeup of anglers? I mean, have you seen the makeup of anglers change to include more women on the water?
Yes, and again, it's because Nancy started this wonderful club, the Bonefish Bonnies. And it's fascinating, as Nancy was saying, when you're catching those fish, it's great fun. But then to know that you've been instrumental in having other women catching fish. And we've had some beginners who just now are hooked, literally and figuratively. So yes, I think what I've seen more is the attitude of a lot of the male guides toward female anglers. And they are quite pleasantly surprised that a lot of female anglers are just as good, if not better than men. There are some of us that need a little always coaching while we're out there trying to catch bonefish, but they're always very patient. And they're all saying that they would rather guide women who follow direction, who understand what the guide is trying to say, instead a lot of their male clients. So I think that's really changing. We're getting more respect as female anglers from the guides, and that goes for the offshore captains as well.
And does anyone else want to put, I mean, I would assume that Lorianne, you've seen that as well. Does anyone else want to comment on that?
I mean, we didn't know. It just exploded. I have to say, I mean, Joan, I totally cracked up. When did you do that interview with the CBS anchorman? When was that? A few years ago?
Yeah, it was in New York City?
Yes. And
oh, well, let's see. I'm so...
Anyway, it was a few years ago.
I think 99.
Oh, no. I think it was a little more recent than that. No, like the recently there was one. Anyway, you said, you were very funny because you said, I didn't realize you were going to be so difficult to teach, which was just totally cracked me up.
Oh, yes, he was terrible.
I was like, oh, Joan is so true to herself. I love that. But you also said in that interview, you said, we've done it. And, you know, Nance, I mean, I think you would agree. It's just like, it's on its own now, Sarah, to answer your question. I mean, it's almost not even, you know, I mean, and in the salt water, it used to be such a big thing. We would never see women. And now, you know, that's a whole change deal. We have women guides. I used to be able to count women guides on my hand. I mean, now hundreds of women guides now. So, you know, I mean, in our lifetime, and this is a special part of this award, and I feel tickled to be a part of it with you, Nancy, because, you know, it is fun for us to, you know, look back and think of, you know, what we didn't know what was going to happen, but, you know, some good things have happened. So that's great.
Yeah, really, really good things.
Yeah. Yeah.
Which is excellent. Fanny, I wondered if you had some words about how women are introduced to fly fishing, because it may be different right now from what it was just a few years ago, but how do people, women, get involved? How do they see it? Fanny.
Who are you asking?
I'm asking you.
Oh, me?
Yes, my dear.
I'm sorry. I didn't understand it. Well, I think basically women most women get into fly fishing in the actual fishing situation through either a friend, a husband, or a boyfriend to start with, but not exclusively, because I know a lot of women who have joined a fly fishing club or have decided with another woman to go and see what this fly fishing was all about. The fishing shows have been a great help. But basically, it's where and when the fishing club reaches out to the female neighborhood, the female who are somewhat interested, a little bit shy about joining a men's group. Some are not, but some are a little bit shy and need a little help. But my experience has been that the woman I have known and met who had heard about fly fishing, but never knew how to get into it or be part of it, when I tell them, you know, just meet somebody and go out there. Maybe you won't know what to do, but maybe you'll learn. And when you learn, you'll know what to do. And not knowing what to do is not a crime. If you really want to learn to fly fish, you will find clubs, you will find schools, and you will find friends who will be very happy to take you under their wings. I encourage as many women, even some who had never thought of it. And then they come back to me and they said, what a wonderful sport. I'm so glad you got me into it. So yes, women and men, but we're talking about women right now. Mm-hmm. Women are very receptive to learning to fly fish and to be good fly fishers. They are. And they respect the sport, they respect the fish, most of them respect the other fly fishers. So it's a win-win situation. You can't lose.
What about the technical side of fishing? Lorianne, what kind of gear changes in gear or fishing techniques have you noticed that help women at all?
Oh, wow. I guess we just totally forgot about that one. Well, you know, yeah, 30 years ago, we really didn't have waders for women. And you know, I'm a tall gal. I could get away with wearing men's waders. But somebody like Joan, you know, a whole foot smaller than me and little feet, you know, that wasn't around for women to even purchase or, you know, remember those all those awful seal waders and everything, and people were walking around very uncomfortable and what's that?
The neoprene waders up north.
Oh, the neoprene waders. We used to call that the weight reduction program. You know, it was like, then oh, here and now I'm sitting in a boat and rowed down the river.
Always too short.
And, you know, and at the beginning there, you know, it was the classic, you know, the husband, wife, and the wife would be in the back of the boat. I'm just going to read a book. And then really, you know, the push, and I remember talking with my dear friend, Lee Perkins at the time, and he said, you know, there just aren't the numbers for it. I said, you know, come on, let's get it. We kept pushing, and Anson was very instrumental in pushing that, because we had to knock down some doors, and eventually, I think it's one of the fastest growing, you know, markets now. I mean, everybody, you walk into any fly shop and they're going to have women representation. It's where that used to be just a little rack in the corner or something like that. Everybody's kind of figured it out. So first of all, women are zipping around there. I see everybody showing up really, you know, snazzy, you know, just all kinds of fun outfits and enjoying the fashion, enjoying being able to have really good equipment. being able to understand the difference between somebody just giving you a rod saying try this versus something that's going to work for you. And so it's really great to see women. And anymore, you know, we used to take on so much as you know, here, let's teach, but women are mentoring each other right and left. I mean, you know, really, you just, like Fanny said, you just set it up, and you know, it's women are really helping each other in a big way. And because there's a lot more women that know what's going on, you know, so it's cool.
It is cool. You know, I have to say about waders, I was wearing these really great waders one time, and a guy came up to me and proposed marriage because I looked so great. It had nothing to do with me, but it was a woman wearing waders, and he thought that was fabulous. And they were great waders. I still have those waders, just in case.
That's pretty funny.
And did you marry the guy?
I didn't marry him, and I never saw him again, which was really
I'd like to say that, yes, that it took 3 years before the first woman came to my fishing school on her own. Otherwise, she came along with her husband so that I guess he could prove that he really was going to fishing on weekends when he left her at home. You know? But the thing that changed everything was a river runs through it.
That's true. Realize it really did. 1992, yeah, that's right. Yes.
And after that movie came out, we had more women than men in the school for 12 years.
Interesting. That's an interesting statistic. That's amazing.
It really is. And so now, you know, things, we have as many women as men in the school now. And it's been so great, you know, to be just hearing what you're talking about and the outfits and everything, and to have been able to see starting from nothing to what we have today. I'm just thrilled, as you can imagine.
What kind of differences, what sort of differences do you see between women anglers and men anglers?
That's doing, not fair, doing what?
Just in, oh, doing fly fishing. I don't mean, or casting. I mean, what do we bring to the table that's a little different than what men bring to the table? Is there anything?
Well, they pay attention to the teachers, whether it's a guide, you know, or whatever. But women tend to take one step at a time, and men are always reaching beyond where they should be. I don't want to say it. That's not a good way to say it, but I have just been thrilled to see. But I said it. I said for 12 years we had more women than men, and that was the film. So men do have an influence on us, as that film showed. Yeah, that's all.
Joan, and I was going to say what Joan was saying about men maybe reaching a little higher than they're ready to, goes back to my point about how the guides see us. They love fishing with women, maybe because we all still blame ourselves for most things. But I've had guides say, you know, when the male angler doesn't follow the instruction or follow where the fish is, they get angry when they don't catch and they blame the guide. So the guides really like us because we're blaming ourselves instead. No, but I mean, we treat the guides, I think, with a little more respect oftentimes. And that's a difference.
Yeah, we listen as well. Yes. So they're out there to give us the best time we can possibly have, and not listening doesn't make sense. Yep.
Totally. Mm-hmm.
And Sarah, at the risk of hogging some time here.
Yes.
I've only been fly fishing for about 7 or 8 years. So I've been blessed with all the modern equipment. But looking back to Bonefish Bonnie, for whom our club is named, there really was a person, Bonefish Bonnie Smith, back in the 40s and 50s. She was a guide. She was a legendary guide here in the Keys. her husband was the first man to catch, well, I think the first person to catch bonefish on fly. She was the first woman to catch a permit on fly. But it's a wonderful, fascinating story. The equipment I've seen, because we have her original rod and reel. Mm-hmm. So I can see the difference from 1940s to where we are today. But one of the fascinating stories about Bonefish Bonnie is that she taught her sisters, Frankie and Beulah, also to teach and to guide, so that when the three husbands went away to war in World War II, they kept the guide business going. And she guided for some really famous men at the time. They also thought that they called it eagle eye, eagle vision, because she was so precise at being able to spot those bonefish. I mean, so our group is named after someone, a woman who really, while she may not be known worldwide, is a legend here in the Keys. And that was all part of Nancy and the original 8 to 20 people. And one last thing, Joan Wulff was Nancy's guest at the very first little luncheon for seven ladies that started the Bonefish Bonnies. So Joan, I've known about you all this time, and it's so nice to meet you.
Thank you. It's so nice to meet you too.
Thank you.
It seems fair to say that first of all, that's a wonderful story, Mary. But it seems fair to say that women on the water have improved the sport of fly fishing, thanks to these inspiring anglers right here on our all women's panel and to our honoree of the evening. I now turn the meeting over. First, before I do, does anyone have any other stories? Joan, I thought that you wanted, I'm hoping that you will grace us with a story about the earlier women that started to fly fish.
Oh, you mean Dame Juliana?
I certainly do.
All right, let me find Dame Juliana here. Yep. It was 527 years ago that the first extant printed words about fly fishing were attributed to Dame Juliana Berners, the treatise of fishing with an angle. And she did such a good job. She included 12 different flies in that manuscript. So you would use a different one for each month of the year. So she was already ahead of other people thinking about the relationship of the bugs without actually talking about it. But she did talk about the flies. And she described the sport as, quote, the best of all recreations. A merry occupation, without care, anxiety, or trouble. And we can all easily agree to that. We don't have any troubles when we're fishing. And there was never any controversy about her. And so she is still the only candidate to have been in that position. I think of her as kind of a mystical mother, you know. And just think about the gap 527 years ago. Easy. You know, I can't help but think. I just had something happen to my Zoom. I just can't help but think that if Nancy Zakon had been around much earlier, that the time could have been shortened dramatically.
Thank you, Joan. The ultimate compliment. Oh my gosh.
Oh.
Thank you, Joan. It's a great story too. It's a great story.
Somebody has to help me on my Zoom screen. I don't have anything on it.
We can see you.
Maybe touch your computer and see if it sparks back up or something. Is it no? Your mouse? Well, we can see you.
I don't want you to. I want to see you. That's what this is all about. Oh, okay.
Here we go. Help.
All right. I'm getting help. Yep.
How did you get help?
because
she's Joan Wulff.
That's not fair. Wait a minute.
Yes, you're absolutely right. It's not fair, but
you snapped your fingers.
No, when you need it. Yeah.
Well.
Okay.
Can anyone else see?
Keep going. We'll catch up.
Okay. Oh, I don't know what happened to my Zoom now. Anyway, does anyone else have any other stories to tell? I now turn the meeting over to Fred Palemas, who may be wishing that he wore a skirt tonight. Fred, with a great smile and lipstick on my lips, please take over. Please take over.
All right, well, Bear, can you all hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, yeah. We're working on a minor detail with my camera, which has somehow decided to bow out at a most awkward moment.
I think this is when we should all be on the water fishing and not dealing with electronics.
Yes.
And a snowstorm.
This is true.
You're going to see me possibly, or you may not, but I want to say that was really fascinating for me to sit and listen to as a guy, because you women have all made significant contributions to the space that a lot of guys probably, it just wouldn't cross their minds. And it's interesting. Here we go. Maybe I'm going to come back. Hey, there I am.
Here you are.
Hey, I'm back too.
Hello, John.
My daughter has started fly fishing a bit, and we don't get a chance to do it very often. But I realize when she does it, she's just a sponge. She's asking tons of questions. She's, you know, trying to figure stuff out, but in a methodical way. And what I was hearing tonight, and Mary got it started, but you all collectively are right in that I think women as a rule, because of patience and because of understanding and because of recognizing that you don't know everything, your ego doesn't get in the way. And, you know, so often that is the case with guys. And so, you know, guys will go out instead of like saying, hey, what am I doing wrong? They just keep doing the wrong thing. And as a result, not catching a whole lot of fish. Whereas I think that women are just, they're better at absorbing information, at taking guidance and advice and all of that stuff that is going to result in one being a better angler and having better outings. But I know also that it's a tough thing that you have all done in what has historically been a male dominated space. The first time I saw Nancy's Zakon was in an Orvis catalog. I had never met Nancy. This was probably, I don't know, sometime in the mid-90s, 94, 95, somewhere in there. And there was a picture of this lovely looking angler. And I thought, wow, that's really cool. You know, I hadn't seen that before. I hadn't seen it in other publications and, you know, other catalogs. I hadn't seen it with Orvis. And all of a sudden, I mean, I knew Joan. Everybody knew Joan, who Joan Wulff was, but all of a sudden the space was opening up. And, you know, Nancy, the contributions that you have made and everyone here tonight, you've paved the road for future generations of anglers, male and female, and hopefully males can maybe learn a little something from the females as to how to approach the pastime so that we don't bang our heads against the wall as much as we do. But you've been a real pioneer. And some of these stories, all of these stories, is testament to that. The contributions that you've made, the accolades that have been bestowed upon you, and it's all because of your good nature, your generous nature. You are passionate about it, and you're willing to share it with others. And that is an incredibly generous thing to do. And B, it so beautifully represents, you know, what this award stands for. So this is really a fun evening for me to listen to these conversations as a guy, and it's been great and really, really enlightening, fun, wonderful stories, all tied to you, Nancy. And you should be, you know, good for you.
Thank you.
You should be so proud. And
I'm very grateful. I am very grateful, is the truth, for all these women that have been in my life, and that we can pass it on to the next. And the next are there to pass it on to. So they're open to it.
Yeah. Look at the opportunities that you've opened and that all of you have opened. For a whole new generation of female fly anglers. And I know it's, you know, I'm sure some of this stuff wasn't easy, like talking about, you know, the saltwater fishing with the waders. And you know, but you did. And you lived through it all, and you're better anglers for it. You're sharing all of that back with the angling community. So I'm humbled and honored to be a part of this evening. I had the great fortune of and privilege of serving alongside Nancy on the board. She was a board member at American Museum of Fly Fishing for many years, as was Alan Zakon, her husband. And it was a lot of fun working with them because, well, first of all, to have a husband and wife team on the board was really cool. It was just, you know, it was something we didn't have. Mm-hmm. And it was really great. The amount of knowledge and insight and perspective that Nancy brought to the board, and she left an indelible mark, and that's one of the reasons that she's a trustee emeritus now. You've done great things. You've done a brilliant job, Nancy, with all that you have to offer, and you've done it so generously and graciously. So good for you.
Thank you. I've loved every minute, and thank you. It's been a joy.
Well, it's been a joy for us. And so I'm not sure now if we get into the award.
I'd just like to say that I never said how I met Nancy. And I met Nancy when she invited me to come and do a promotional day at the Orvis store in New York. And I walked in there, and there was this woman who was actually an employee of Orvis. I had never met a woman employee in the fishing tackle department of anything. And so
I bet some of that wasn't easy, right?
I understand
a lot.
she was making lists of women that she met who would be interested in fishing. And so she got in touch with them, and for the day that I was there, I think there were, according to Sara Low, who was there, there were 50 women who came through that day. That was a large number in 1995. It really
was.
Wow. Yep. Yeah. But she had made those lists, and she had followed up. And that's the kind of woman she is. She doesn't just do the top little first layer. She goes deep, deep, deep.
Oh,
I admire that so much about you.
Can do woman.
Yeah, and I saw that very much when Nancy was serving on the board. She really immersed herself. She dove in head first into whatever it was that we asked her to contribute to, and she did it, you know, just always with a smile on her face and always with lots of enthusiasm and you know, graciousness. So so now's the time to present this award to you, Nancy. I hope that it means a lot to you. For those of you out there who cannot see what this award reads, I'm gonna read it to you. The Izaak Walton 2023 award, Nancy Zakon honoring her passion for the sport of fly fishing as a teacher, industry trailblazer, mentor, innovator, and philanthropist. And boy, that's just spot on. And the only thing I'd like to add is good friend.
And that is
a huge part, as we all know, of the fly angling community, is the friendships we develop. So congratulations, Nancy. I hope that this means a lot to you. It means a lot to us. And We're thrilled for you.
I love you, Nancy.
We all love you, Nancy.
I love you, Dad. I love you, Dad.
We all love you, Nancy.
Fanny and Fred.
We all love you. All thrilled. So
it means a huge amount to me, and I'm totally over the moon and thrilled. Thank you. Thank you. It's been a pleasure working with you all. And you all mean a lot to me in my life. So
can we make a date with you to go fishing?
Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
Let's set up a fishing trip together. Okay. All of us.
Oh, I know. This has been so wonderful to get together at the powwows for this. It's like, it's just been historic, really. And wonderful. Great shot in the arm for me. Great shot in the arm for me.
Thank you,
so
dear.
Wonderful, Nance.
All right, honey. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Nancy. Thank you.
Thank you, Nancy.
Yeah, Nancy, would you be willing to say a few words just before we sign off on things? Is there anything that you'd like to share with the listening public out there? I'm sure there are a lot of folks who'd love to hear.
I've always loved fly fishing since my father took me to the pond across the road. The beauty of it, the silence of it, the wonder of nature, the fascination of nature, and the thrill of becoming part of that nature is just a magical experience. And I hope more women can see this and feel comfortable to go into the fly shop or go with a friend to fish. You don't have to know it all to begin with. You're not being judged. And going with other women is very supportive. I think we all feel, you know, we've all fished with other women. And when one catches a fish, it's though we've all caught that fish. We're so supportive of each other. And the companionship is precious. The time on the water is precious because you're away from family, you're away from cooking, you know, childcare, everything. You give your mind a spa, I call it. And it's a beautiful experience that you'll want to return to. And now that there's so many ways to approach it, I hope women out there can take advantage of that and enjoy it the way we've enjoyed it. We want to pass it on to you. Thank you.
You're doing a wonderful job in that, and all of you are. And so thank you. Again, thank you for your generosity, Nancy, and your enthusiasm and the whole nine yards. And I just want to say a few closing words. First, I want to thank all of you. I want to thank Mary and Joan and Lorianne and Fanny, and especially Sarah for emceeing this evening and asking some great questions and drawing some really interesting information out of folks. It's been a lot of fun. This is definitely the first all-female panel that we've had for an Izaak Walton Award. I think it's been great, and it's been very enlightening for me. And I just can't thank you all enough. And I think a few of us will be gathering with Nancy tomorrow as well. For those of you who can't, we'll certainly be thinking about you and just really can't thank you enough. And it's been a fun evening. So I feel very honored to be a part of it, Nancy.
We'll be with you tomorrow in spirit.
Yes.
In
spirit. Yes, we will. Yes, we will. Thank you.
Oh, thank you.
I'll hug you for all of them.
Thank you, Mary.
That's a deal. And we'll get together again. Good night, all.
All right. Good night. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Have a good evening.
Sarah, thank
so
you.
Much.
Thank, thank you. Everyone. Thank you, Sarah. I want to say bye.
Thank you,
Sarah. Good evening. Good evening.